Alright guys, welcome back. Another Switch emulator video for you. I'm using YUZU latest update. Alright, I will be using 6 devices. One low end, one mid range, and consider 4 the high end SoC. This is a Redmi Note 8. Oh, alright, the RAM already optimized. Latest update of YUZU. Let me see. What are the updates? What's new? Import firmware file. This one is important. Import firmware file. The rest improve UI, add new error message, include latest change from upstream user. Well, nothing changed in the performance, but one thing important. Alright, I'll show you. For this Mario 8 KART. Oh, let me clear the cache first. This is a low end Snapdragon 665. On setting, whether you are using the paid or the free version, everything the same. Don't worry. And in the setting over here, there is another option. Install firmware. Get your firmware. I'm using the latest one, 16.03. Installing the firmware. Right, so product key was still the same. Install the amiibo keys. This one also some game using the amiibo, like the Legend of Zelda. CPU, this one is up to you. Play around with it. It will do no harm to your device unless you are using Magis. This one, please be very very careful. Wrong driver, boot loop, even worse, break. Right, Mario Kart Deluxe, and the setting general. This video might be a bit long, just stay with me. Let's try reduce down to 540. So, the rest, alright. Low end device, 4GB of RAM. See, compiling the shaders perfectly on Snapdragon 665. There is another 4GB of RAM, Redmi Note 9S. Well, loading the game a bit slow compared to the Snapdragon 870. Change the driver of this Redmi Note 9S. While waiting for that one, so should you try the okay, and we have 615 37. Come on, loading. Depend on your CPU. This is a low-end CPU. What do you expect from it? See the because the RAM just 4 GB. Actually, it's not enough. I'm using the virtual RAM, swapping the RAM from the actual RAM to the internal storage UFS. So part of your internal storage are used as RAM, but the speed are not as fast as the actual RAM. Game loading, but a bit slow. While waiting for it to load, let's start the minus. Same setting of all. Four GB of RAM also. All right, let's begin. Over here, the problem. If you don't use the firmware, this one will be blank. After this, I show you which device. That one blank. All devices are using the same setting, the same firmware. Minus. Come on. Oh, sorry, wrong button. Check. Redmi Not to see right there. Can use a touchscreen also. The game support touchscreen. Right, we start this one. 9S. While waiting for game to start, single player. Okay. Don't have to push the A, even this one also can. Okay. G, 4 GB. 665 4 GB. This one start first, which one loading first? 720. Sorry for the reflection there. After this, Snapdragon 845, 855, 860, and the last one 870. For this game, better using the Mesa 3D driver, Mesa Turnip. If your device supports the driver, then use it. It might improve the performance a bit compared to the normal Falcon. Raising 9S, it's not running there. Wow, this one start here. 9S status. See? Not yet. Like. Not bad. Not bad. But the FPS only 10. That because already reduced to 540p. Still slow. This one faster. 665 or 720. Slow motion. Six, six, five. This one, 9 FPS. Resolution. Five forty p also. This one 540p also. More or less the IPS. Only 1 IPS better. Or 9 IPS. Well, don't worry, maybe in the future the speed might improve. Still running, even though it got 4 GB of RAM only. Right, Poco F1 Snapdragon 845, same setting. How about the driver? Software already installed. 615 version 4. This one can also using the Mesa 3D. Here you can see the setting at default resolution using up by linear 969 using shadow sketch, same setting except this one resolution at default. Those two reduced to 540p, this one 720p. ST855, H60, H70, the last one. LG V50, Poco X3 Pro, and Poco F3. So, 3 Poco, Poco F1, Poco F3, and Poco X3 Pro, except the X3 NFC, still up there, sleeping. Haven't updated. I need to update the software. Maybe tomorrow I'm using the X3 NFC, so stay tuned. this notch. Come on, come on. Right. See. Even I use the firmware, 845 missing. How about 855? Same setting, all device. Same firmware. 855. Whoa. What happened to you? LG V50 and Poco X3 Pro. New custom ROM, Aero OS. Every custom ROM I already test. crdroid, Evolution X, you name it. Why SD665 can view the MII, how do you call this one?
Mario Kart
8! LG V50. Ha ha ha. Poco X3 Pro. LG V50. Poco F1 SD 845. Last one. Same setting. Except this one, the driver. No GPU driver. Let's try the. Where's my driver? Where's my driver? Is it trick? 3-2-3-3-1-0. Sorry. 3-2-0-3. Let's check. Mesa 3D. Okay, let's try this one. How come this one can play SD665 and 720? The low end and the high end SOC and the last one, Poco F3. Shut up, Poco F1. Bagi malu lah, Poco F3. No problem. So 845, 855, 860 problem, 870, 888, 871, 8 Gen 1, this one no problem. This one loading faster. Poco F3. Why? Even the LG also problem. 855. 845, 855, 860. Well, 870. +20, I guess. Why? Who's shooting at me? 20 plus to 30 plus. The range. Hey, why the button not functioning? somewhere 20 plus 30 FPS. Still slow motion. Damn. Accept the motion. No motion control. Well, well, well. Quit. See, even the touchscreen can be used. Well, thumbs up to the YUZU team. A bit improvement on the emulator itself, but the speed, if you compare to the chicken egg, the dead chicken egg, much faster than this. But in terms of graphic, this YUZU are much better, except the speed. The only, well, I'm broken hearted with this 845, 855 and 860. If you got these three devices, please be patient. Just wait for them to fix the problem. And once again, thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next video.